here we are, and here you are, and it's great that you are here, and now football is coming back to life. So how does FIFA support its 211 member associations on both a regular basis and to achieve its long-term objectives?
Yeah, I know that not everyone will be the specialist of it, but FIFA is helping a lot and helping all its member associations. On a daily basis, with a program that we call FIFA Forward program, which is a program that have been implemented in 2016 when Gianni Infantino got elected the first time. And we've been multiplying by fourfold the amount of money that we are sending to the MAs in order to develop football. So this Forward program is part of the programs that I am running with the MA division. Almost $2 billion US dollar on the cycle from 2019 until 2023. And this program is basically aiming at achieving the FIFA vision, which is making football truly global. So this is the first part of it.
Yes.
Then there is a second part. Unfortunately, we had to face this pandemic, this COVID-19 pandemic last year.
Yes.
And we needed to find solutions, concrete solutions to member associations where they needed to face matches which were suspended at some point, tournaments and competitions suspended. And then after the suspension of this tournament, in order to resume, you had those COVID protocols. And the COVID protocols applied for the national team matches, but also for the local competition. So we needed to help them. Some of them, they lost sponsors. Some of them, they lost ticketing revenues. It was an intense and difficult period for all the family of football. And with the COVID relief plan that we set up last year, we've been able to save most of our stakeholders' life. And now I'm very happy to see that even now, we are still continuing to implement this program. Even now, we bear the fruit of what we set up last year. It was not an easy one. This $1.5 billion US dollar program that we made based on the reserves that we had also from the past. It was not easy to set up. It was not easy to implement. It was not easy even to think.
Of course.
But finally, I can say today that it has been helpful for all our stakeholders, from member association, but also from the confederations.
But how do you go about what must be a huge task on a global scale?
Yeah, it is a challenge. I have to say it is a big challenge because it is basically dealing with 211 clients in a way. But yeah, it is more than client because the 211 are the parliament of football. So I am nothing in this institution. I'm just a messenger, just trying to apply what my members want. So it is, yes, a complex challenge. But for this, we've got an organization here at FIFA. But not only in Zurich here in the home of football, but also all around the world, because we've got, in addition to my team here in Zurich, 11 regional offices close to the member associations in order to help them to set up their program, to set up the projects, and to accompany them in their projects.
What are the other objectives of this kind of investment? How do football fans all over the world see the differences made?
Oh, you can see the difficulty with football is that usually in the media, they don't highlight those great stories that we have in developing football. But I've got so many examples of life-changing projects.
Tell us, please.
Yeah, for example, I will take the recent example that I experienced because I was in Benin recently. And I saw this final school championship that we managed to deploy with the help of the Benin government.
Yeah, it was jointly organized.
Yeah, it was jointly organized by FIFA, the government, and the member association of Benin. And I saw in the faces of the children playing this final stage, it was amazing because it was like if a dream was coming true to them. So basically, this example is a very good one. I've got a second one, a recent one, because we contributed to refurbish the national stadium in Cabo Verde. Mm-hmm. And I remember this phrase of the the national coach, who is a former player of the national team. And he was almost crying, saying that the very last time he played in this stadium, he was still a player. So he was so proud to see that with the help of the FIFA Forward funds and the accompaniment of the local municipality and the government, we have been able to reopen this stadium to all the people in Cabo Verde, not only from the main island, but also from the other islands. So huge, huge.